Hi, my name is Megan Strominis, and I work with the Girl Scouts of Central Maryland. For those of you that don't know where Central Maryland might be located, it is on the eastern shore of the United States, more specifically just right by Washington, D.C., and you can see it on the map right there. At the Girl Scouts of Central Maryland, I am the STEM specialist, so I get to do programs and activities with girls that relate to STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. And today, I am going to be helping our Daisies do part of our Cybersecurity Basics badge. And we're going to learn all about how to keep information safe on the computer by using layers of protection. So just like when you are leaving your house, you or your parents are going to lock the door. If I'm going to go out into the sun, I'm going to make sure that I have sunscreen on to add layers of protection. So when we're thinking about our devices, our computers, or our phones, or anything like that, we want to make sure that we have a lot of layers of security and protection to keep our information that's stored on those devices safe. So for our activity today, we are going to be protecting a treasure of ours. So what we're going to need is we're going to need to find a treasure. We're going to need a box that our treasure is going to fit into, some things to decorate that box with, maybe paint, markers, crayons, pencils, stickers, and then we're going to need things to protect that. So some things that you might use to protect your treasure box might be wrapping paper, bubble wrap, maybe some fabric, anything that'll help protect it, string, tape. And what we're going to do with these materials is we're going to do that. And I'm going to go ahead and show you what I've created and what treasure I'm going to be protecting. So I went and I was thinking about something that was really special and important to me, just like you girls should do. And I have a hockey puck that my grandparents gave me that is just so very special to me. And I want to keep it nice and safe. And I then found a box that my treasure will fit into. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put my treasure in my box. Nice and safe. All right, so my treasure is now in my box. What I'm going to do is I'm going to decorate my box. So we want our treasure to be special and decorated. So I'm going to write Megan's treasure on this. And then we can go ahead and continue to decorate this however you like. It does not matter how you decorate it as long as it's special to you. So I'm gonna do some blue, maybe kind of color it a little bit, and decorate my box. And you can use whatever kind of craft materials that you have for this creation. So decorate mine just a little bit. And then I'll show you how I'm going to protect this treasure of mine. All right. So as you're decorating your box, you want to try and think about what you're going to do to protect your treasure. So when I'm on the computer, I make sure that I protect my information by not saying anything that wouldn't be safe to share. I don't tell anybody my information or where I live online. And I also make sure that I'm using passwords. I'm only using websites that are safe. So now that I have my treasure and I decorated my box, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add different layers of protection for this treasure because I don't want my hockey puck that's in here to be nice and safe. So I'm going to wrap it with a couple different things. So I have some felt paper that's nice and soft that I think will do a really good job of protecting my treasure. And I'm going to wrap it, and I'm going to use some tape, and we are going to wrap and protect our box. I'm going to tape it on. Just like this. And you don't have to use what I'm using. You can use whatever you have to try and keep your treasure safe. All right. But once I add this layer of protection, I'm thinking I might want to do something else to keep it nice and safe, because it's always safe to have multiple layers of protection and different layers of security. So I'm going to also use some packing paper to cover this once more. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cover my box with this packing paper to keep it nice and safe. And I'm going to again tape it. You can use tape, you can use string, whatever you think is best to keep your treasure safe. So I'm going to put a little piece of tape on it, and I'm also going to add some string so that it does not come apart and it's really hard for somebody to get to my treasure box. So as you're thinking about your treasure, you want to think how you're going to keep that safe, what you're going to use to keep that safe, and maybe why you're keeping that safe. I'm keeping my hockey puck safe because it's something that's very special to me. My grandparents gave it to me and I've had it for a very long time, and I want it to stay nice and safe. And just like all of my information on the internet, I want to protect it with as many layers of security as I can. So think about your treasure, think about how you're going to protect it, and also as you're protecting your treasure, think about how you're protecting your information online when you're using the computer and you're using any of your devices. So if you had fun doing this activity with me today, you can check out girlscouts.org to see some more really fun Daisy activities that you can do. And if you're not already a Girl Scout, you can reach out to your local Girl Scout Council to learn about becoming a Girl Scout, or if your parents want to become a Girl Scout leader, you can go ahead and do that. Thank you for learning about protecting your information with me, and happy Girl Scouting.